Hello, magandang hapon po sa lahat. Good afternoon. So without further ado, let's discuss now Microsoft solutions for business continuity and disaster recovery. So type 1 nga po for all those who are tuning in, type 1. So mauna na ako, type 1. Okay, let's see sino po ang attendees natin who are tuning in. Okay, ang dami, alright. I'm happy to be with you today. So it's a good ano no, it's a good week. Hopefully yung ano, yung environment natin, yung weather, mas magtuloy-tuloy, hindi masyadong maulan. So let's start. Okay. Because we're talking about IT and how we can prevent yung damages into our business. Okay. Titingnan po natin no. Ano po ba yung ano in relation to IT, okay, and the business, diba? The IT now is your digital estate. Again, your IT is your digital estate. And with your digital estate, you are running the business. So, in more example po, no, diba may mga sikat na basketball players, sila Kobe Bryant, sila yung magaling mag 3 points sa Warriors, di ba? Yung nagbigay ng ano nila na sponsorship na Under Armour, ang sabi nila, we are not a apparel business. Si Stephen Curry, tama po, Ma'am Luar, yung Under Armour, they are not apparel business anymore. They are a technology company. And so we are. Tayo pong lahat, no? We are a technology company. So now, the impact of digital disruptions on our digital business has huge implications. Una-una sa lahat, doon sa mga boss natin, yung mga may-ari, okay? Pangalawa, sa produkto, yung brand natin, it can affect once mawalan tayo ng service. Sabihin natin, for example, Friday, okay? Friday na Friday, no? Tapos nag-down yung system natin. And then that system is external facing. So ma-affect yung brand natin. Okay, may magtatampong customers. And the most important of all, sa atin po, na we are an IT practitioner. Lahat po tayo na nandito, no? It can impact our careers. Sabi nga sa DevOps book na nabasa ko, you have one job, okay? To keep the systems running, okay? So, let's see what are the causes of these disruptions. Unang-una sa lahat, systems failure. Okay? Sino po ba dito ang naka-experience na ng mga systems failure of some sort sa IT or external sa mga ginagamit niyong services? Type 2 nga po, type 2, sino po mga naka-experience na mga systems failure sa inyong company or anything sa bahay? Okay. Ang dami po, alright. Ang dami. So, systems failure, ang dami po niya, no? We cannot imagine na mawawala yan because it is simply the way of life, okay? God given us yung capability to create things and that things can break, di ba? Systems failure is inevitable. Salamat po sa mga sumagot. Second, power failure, okay? Since sa Philippines, no, we are still developing yung multiple sources of electricity natin through our supplier, no? So meron tayong mga power generator, but we all know marami pong ano factors kung kailan yan mawawala or diba, kung mapapansin nyo, may mga scarcity ngayon ng mga resources. No? Mali natin, pati yung power natin maging scarce na rin. Diba? So, that are some of the ano. And another part is natural disasters. Nakarelate tayo dyan. Bata pa lang tayo, lagi na tayong ano, binabaha. Cyber attack. So, ang cyber attack po is intentional, okay? And then, meron pa dyan mga script kiddies, mga bumili lang ng mga software to attack. Meron din naman po state level attacks, no? Which is may binibiling serbisyo para ma-atake yung mga small and medium business, government, enterprises. Kung mapapansin nyo po, no, ang hindi natin maiwasan, na kaya naman pala nating iwasan or ma-manage, saan po dito? Unang-una sa lahat yung number one. Okay, kayang-kaya po natin i-manage yan. So, we'll share to you po, no, later on, paano po natin gagawin yon. Ngayon, sa atin pong IT practitioners, when we state value, kung kailangan po ba natin ito, okay, yung solution for disaster recovery and backup, ngayon, saan natin nahagilapin? Saan yung value proposition and saang papeles dapat nakikita yon? Unang-una sa lahat, sa atin sa IT po, no, kung kayo man po ay CTO, CIO, manager, IT practitioner, admin, okay, nakita po yan, yung mga plano na yan, unang-una sa enterprise risk management document. Sa mga enterprise, meron po niyan. Gumagawa po ang mga IT or mga department heads sa negosyo mismo ng business impact analysis. Kung sakali po ba na nagka-disrupt doon sa sistema natin, importante ba yan, dapat always on? Kasi pag nawala isang server, okay, meron bang hahalili or papalit doon sa server po ba na yun? So that's ano, a prioritization of what matters most in terms of digital assets. Secondly, business continuity plan. Because of the processes right now sa negosyo po natin is nag-digitally transformed na po, di ba? Yung finance natin napunta sa IT, yung HRIS natin napunta sa IT, the way we deliver yung services natin napunta sa IT. So the way the business can continue is to sustain, di ba, yung IT. So makita niyo po yung plano na yan sa business continuity plan. And kapag napunta naman sa IT, may tinatawag po na disaster recovery plan. And then kapag hindi pa rin natin na ano, nagawa yung document na to, let's refer all, lahat po tayo, doon sa data privacy law, no, na nagawa noong 2012. So may 2012 po ito, okay, Data Privacy Act of 2012 sa panahon ni ano, President Aquino po. So kaya, what if, okay, there's an event, di ba? Hindi natin maiiwasan. So ano po bang normal na ginagawa natin, di ba? Sabihin natin sa mga IT po dito. Sino pong IT dito? Number 3 nga po. Can you type number win? Number 3, sorry. Number 3, sino pong mga IT practitioners dito? Can you type number 3 po? Okay. So, ang dami po, no? Okay, ang daming number 3. Thank you po sa mga IT practitioners natin dyan. And everyone po, no? Maski mga may-ari, mga managers natin, mga heads, they are all IT practitioners. So the event, like what we are seeing on the picture, is what we call yung ano na, delayed ano na, response. Okay, delayed response to the danger that has happened. Okay, yung result po ng lack of planning, lack of execution doon sa pangangailangan natin ng disaster recovery plan systems and backup systems. Ganito na po yung nangyari sa atin. Okay. So ako na experience ko po 'yan, no. I haven't worked with an end user for the past more than 10 years po. I've worked with different customers, banks, conglomerates, and majority of the businesses po ng sa government, lahat po ng ano, sa government, SSS, Pag-IBIG. Ayan po. Marami rin pong instance na ganito. So, kailangan nyo pong, may mga nagdadasal dahil nga, they don't know kung babagsak ba yung system nila na nakaharap nila, di ba? Yung server. May mangyari, di ba? May kulay amber po doon sa server. Yung umiilaw na storage, may amber. Ang worthy ng IT, may backup ba tayo nito? Ngayon, magtatanong yung tao na yun. Meron nga ba? Have we planned for this? Have we executed on this? What can I do? So the moment now you ask, what can I do? Is late na po yung pangyayari na yun. So ngayon, ang ginagawa na po namin nun, let's pray na hindi yan ano, bumagsak ngayon kasi uuwi pa tayo sa pamilya natin mamayang gabi. Okay. At meron pang kinabukasan. So doon tayo mag-execute. So ito po no, ito po yung imminent na dangers po or mga inevitable happenings no na hindi natin maiwasan once we do not execute doon sa mga ano sa mga plans. And there are many strategies naman po no, maraming strategy. Unang-una sa lahat, okay? Ang pinaka makapag-secure na always available, okay? Ibig sabihin lagi pong nagki-cater yung sistema ninyo. Your systems are always catering to your customers is the high availability type of system. Ayan po, highly available systems are normally okay, applications that are distributed. Meaning to say, for example, kung meron kayong web server, multiple ano po 'yan, web servers, 2-3 or more, okay? 'Yan po yung highly available. Kung may database naman po kayo, sa isang server, meron pong isa pang server na backup or standby. 'Yun po yung mga highly available na systems. So 'yan po yung always available, no. And then next naman, in terms of total breakage, sabihin po natin no, nasira po yung isang data center or yung buong server rack ninyo. Meron pa bang pwedeng meron ba tayong system that can run few minutes after ng disaster doon sa system natin or doon sa rack of data servers. So yan po yung disaster recovery. Okay? In the few minutes after the event na masira yung mga servers natin, one or two servers, pwede po natin siyang i-run agad after a few minutes. So that is disaster recovery. You can plan for this sa data center din po ninyo or easier and mas cost-effective, okay? And mas magaan na gamitin at gawin is do it on cloud, the cloud systems. And lastly, for the business continuity strategy is yung tinatawag natin na backup. Okay, ngayon makarelate po sa backup, no? Sino po dito yung mga gumagamit dati ng USB thumb drive po? To USB thumb drive. So I believe marami po sa atin na gumagamit ng USB thumb drive, no? Diyan po natin nilalagay yung mga files natin, yung mga pictures, di ba, sa USB thumb drive. So that has been improved na. Yung practice na ganun, okay, yung i-relate natin sa server, okay? We normally do on-premises backup, okay? Sa kabilang server or we buy a new server with a software, backup software, okay? But the most cost-effective way for backup solutions and worry-free, okay, is to backup with cloud solutions that can do on-premise at the same time, iba-backup din po niya papuntang cloud, okay? So that's the most cost-effective way. So in an event po na mag-shutdown, masira yung system, few hours after the event, you can restore yung service. Ayan po yung mga business continuity strategy. So tatlo po yan. Again, high availability, disaster recovery, and backup. So we are talking about these two. Disaster recovery and backup. So we will capture a solution for you about this scenarios. And then, the most amazing thing kay cloud with Microsoft Azure, so compliant po siya in the standard unang-una sa data privacy law natin and the global standard of compliance and security. So ang tinutukoy po natin dito is the data center, the area kung saan po nandun yung mga servers and data centers. Yan po yung compliance nila. So let's talk naman po doon sa specific. When we are doing disaster recovery, okay, using Azure Site Recovery. So The technology now for disaster recovery is what we call Azure Site Recovery. Again, the technology is Azure Site Recovery. So with Azure Site Recovery, from on-premises, kung makita niyo po dito, if you are running your systems, physical, di ba? Meron po tayong tower-type servers, or you have your hypervisors, nag-virtualize kayo, nagko-containerize kayo po ng mga servers. You may have VMware, or you may also have Hyper-V. Yan. All of that are supported systems. You can sync it towards the cloud na po. Okay. Ibig sabihin po, lahat ng changes in real time, doon ang nangyayari, na nangyayari doon sa systems ninyo, all of the changes, delta changes, beta changes, are synchronized to Microsoft Azure storages. So meaning to say, if your digital assets, okay, are, let's say, you want to execute a disaster recovery plan, okay? You want to test. Sabihin natin, kung sakali ba na nasira yung system natin, mag-run ba tayo sa cloud after a few minutes? So one example po, no? Sino po dito ang nag-Netflix? O Netflix, sino pong mahilig manood ng ano dyan? Yung mga bagong palabas, okay? Si Netflix, mahilig po yan mag-test ng disaster recovery, okay? So they are running on cloud din po, no? What they do is buong data center po yung sina-shutdown nila. They call that sys practice chaos monkey. Okay? Chaos monkey. So test natin kung mag-run tayo sa ibang location after natin ma-down yung isang data center. So sa atin naman, we can do that also. We can test kung after the planned disaster, can we run on cloud? So yes, you can do that. You can test it using disaster recovery, Azure Site Recovery. Ayan. So, simplified lang din po ito. The charges of Azure Site Recovery are more of an operational expense. Unang-una, kung ano po yung kinonsumo ng storage ninyo. Let's say, 1 terabyte po yung servers. Yung server ninyo, yung total storage. Yun lang po yung ano monthly na binabayaran ninyo sa Azure Site Recovery. Okay? With per server, meron kayong binabayaran na $25 each. So imagine, sobrang liit po ng footprint ng charges ninyo. And in the event na mag-testing po kayo ng disaster recovery, doon lang po nag-i-incur yung charges ng buong virtual machine na nirerun nyo doon sa cloud. Okay. So this is by far the most cost-effective disaster recovery solution para sa inyo. So para sa atin sa IT, no? So can you show us how we do it? So normally, kung meron kayong mga servers on-premises, so lahat po yan, it is being processed by a site recovery server. Okay? Site recovery server. And the data ng mga systems ninyo will be replicated and synced doon sa cloud na po. So protected po yan, no? Encrypted via port 443. Ayan. So yan po yung mechanism na nangyayari. So in the event that you are sabihin natin you are testing. So meron po yung recovery time and recovery point objective of 1 minute up to 5 minutes. So mabilis lang po. And then additional pa po yung yung pagboot ng servers ninyo. So normally yun lang po, less than an hour mag-run na po yung systems nyo sa Microsoft Azure. So next topic natin, so kanina we discussed yung disaster recovery, the fastest way that you can recover your systems. Ngayon, let's talk about the backup. So backing up onto the cloud is is a smart thing to do. So if you are using, let's say you have an iPhone, you have Google, di ba? You have experienced it also na sa Google Drive, sa iCloud, it is a smartest way to ano, to manage yung files ninyo, no? Ganon din po sa IT, sa digital assets. When we move the backup towards the cloud where they can best manage yung data natin, nawawala yung burden sa IT. And we are assuring the business that yes, we are good to go. We always have backup for the entire month. Diba? Sasabihin pa po natin, we always have backup for the entire 6 months or even for the entire 50 years. So yun po yung sasabihin natin sa business. Okay? So, kaya po ang mga government enterprises, they are doing a cloud-first backup. Ayan. And then, amazingly, ang charges din po nito ng cloud backup is we charge as you consume the storage. If the server again is 1 terabyte, okay, and then ang total consumption po is, let's say, sabihin natin, 1.5 terabytes sa cloud, yun lang po ang chinacharge ni Microsoft Azure. And then, in the event na gusto nyong mag-restore ng data sa cloud na din, so yun, another charge pa po yun, but minimal lang din po. So the best part of this is up to 99 years po yung ano, retention ng backup natin sa cloud. Entire lifetime po. And again, 'di ba? Normally when you buy backup solutions, ang capacity expense niya, 'di ba? Sobrang mahal po. But with Microsoft Azure backup, ang binabayaran po natin ito is operational expense. Kaya we are saving the business money. Okay, may mas paggagamitan pa kayo ng pera sa IT budget ninyo. Okay. So for supported systems na pwedeng i-backup. So normally po ang supported system ng Azure backup is ayan, majority is Microsoft Windows servers, mga file servers po ninyo. Or even yung VMware. Ayan, supported po yung VMware natin. And ang nabanggit ko po kanina, no? So, ang sinasabi mo, James, we can backup to cloud. Pero ang ginagawa namin ngayon, we backup on-premise. So, there's a good news po sa inyo, no? May good news po sa inyo. The Azure backup server, itong nasa screen nyo po, sa right side, is provided po sa inyo yung software. Azure backup server software that you can install on your Windows server. Ano po yan? Kasama po doon sa charge, monthly charges po ninyo. So that can backup your systems una on-premise. So may backup kayo on-premise. After backing up on-premise, di ba? Now, the Azure backup server pushes the copy of the backup to cloud. So may 2 copies na po kayo ngayon using the Azure backup server. So isn't it amazing? Okay. Using Azure backup, you have both copies from on-premise to cloud. Ayan. So kaya po nakalagay dito, oh, the software cost is free because kung ano po yung kinukonsume ng pang na-backup ninyo, let's say again 1.5 terabytes. Yun lang po yung China charge. The software cost of Azure backup server, kasama na po yung charge doon sa na-consumong storage sa cloud. Compared to your backup vendors, mga nagbibenta ng backup solutions, this is the most cost-effective, okay? Cost-effective po ang Azure backup solution. So, in terms of drawing, so ganito niya binabackup, yung mga systems po natin na nag-run sa data center natin, so may agent po yan, binabackup doon sa Azure backup server, okay? And then it replicates to the cloud po, encrypted via port 443. Ayan po. And at rest yung data ninyo is naka-encrypt din po. So you are secured doon sa Microsoft Azure. In the event na gusto niyo mag-restore, So let's say gumawa kayo ng VM dito. Another charge naman po 'yon. Hindi kayo agad-agad na sisingilin, okay, doon sa virtual machine na ni-restore ninyo. Kaya mas makakatipid po kayo as a business using Azure Backup. So that's an awesome sharing for me. So hopefully you have learned on this session. And if you have any question po, so babasahin na po natin yan on your chat box.